Hello, my name is Lightness Thomas. We are in front of you, we are students from Sokoine University of Agriculture, pursue degree program of rural development. We are here to explain about the administration management of EduCare Secondary School, which is private organization, and Mafiga A Primary School, which is government organization.
I'm Irene John. I'm here to present the private sector known as EduCare Secondary School. The history of EduCare Secondary School is a school that was established in 1998 that is under 8 members ownership of a company known as EduCare Company Limited. The school provides better education and quality one to the student, that is both life education and school education. The structure and organization of EduCare Secondary School for the higher level starts with the owner of the school, followed by the board of directors, with and a manager. There is a headmaster, there is assistant headmaster, followed by senior academic master, followed by assistant academic master. Within the academic structure, there is different departments such as natural science, social science, and language, whereby there are different teachers who organize the department. Then followed by other relation staffs such as discipline masters, environmental masters, and sport masters. Then followed by the school government, which is made by students themselves, that is head boy, head girl, and other prefects. And the other structure is non-teaching staff members, which is comprised with one cook, one personal secretary, environmental keeper, and security guard. Of working in EduCare Secondary School is as follows. Firstly, the school uses different working techniques such as the home package for students, followed by class quiz and assignment, weekly test, and remedial program. The other technique is all the staff members should prepare the plans for work syllabus of academic year. The second is the staff members have different manual work to the school students and other class works, which will help them to be very effectively.
Currently, I'm explaining about staff relationship and workers' motivation at the EduCare Secondary School. Starting with staff relationship, at EduCare Secondary School, they are well organized. They are communicating well between each other in different matters, not only about organization, but also social matters. In motivation, at EduCare Secondary School, workers are being motivated by giving some rewards, whereby their teachers who help the students in certain classes to perform well are given some money. Due to that, the performance increases at the school. Workers committee are divided into academic committee, which deals with academic matters, discipline committee, which deals with discipline of the students and manners of their school compound, but also religious committee, which are under the school pastor and deals with spiritual matters in the school. And another committee is sport and games, which deals entertainment and sports at school organization. Administration communication. In administration communication, the staff meetings which are conducted at EduCare Secondary School, whereby during those staff meetings they are discussing different matters of their organization, various issues that are connected to school organization, and in fact they are a big part of the organization to function properly. And management of human resources. In EduCare Secondary Schools, control the human resource management at the school by following the rules and the regulation of employees. Financial management in Educare Secondary School, they depend only on student fees, which they use those fees to pay the workers and run the organization. And the last thing is Tanzania policies, laws and acts which affect the management of Educare Secondary Schools. There are laws and acts which are affecting the management of Educare Secondary School, like the free education policy. This affecting the organization whereby many parents they took their children to government schools, and that affected the school organization because they get few number of students, and also frequent change of syllabus. This affected the school organization, in fact that they have to also change their teaching curriculum every time the government changes that the government change the academic performance that being affected. Organization as general is private, that is required to pay some tax to the government. This also limits the performance of the organization as its financial status is not that big.
Daniel, I'm here to present Mafiga A Primary School. Mafiga A Primary School, it is a government primary school, means it is owned by government. Mafiga A Primary School, it was established in 1975. I'm going direct to the organization and management of the Mafiga A Primary School. Mafiga A Primary School, at the top, it is a government-owned school. Then it is followed by a headmaster and secondary master and discipline master and various staffs. Various staffs is contain both employed staffs and non-employed staffs of working plan at Mafiga A Primary School. Mafiga, all the teachers, they used to prepare a lesson plan before teaching students. Secondly, teachers always promote and encourage students to participate in different activities such as curricular activities and non-curricular activities, meaning that sports and games. Then management of human resources of Mafiga A Primary School. Human resources at Mafiga A Primary School are being controlled well by the government, following the rules and regulation of the government. Then I'm going to staff relation, motivation and workers committees. Staff, there is a good relationship between staffs of Mafiga A, teachers and the students who performed well in their subjects, they have been given our awards.
Hello, my name is Musa Albert and I'm going to present about the administrative communication, financial management and the Tanzania policies, laws and acts which affect and how they affect the functioning of the school. The administrative communication of the school is pretty well organized through frequent meetings of the headmaster and the school teachers, and the communication seems to work well because it solves different problems and how they live in the certain school. Financial management is really not that much because they get funds from the government. The Tanzanian policies, acts and laws of the government and how they affect the function of the school is that through the introduction of the free education or the Elimbure, the school was affected because it doesn't get enough funds to run the school. For example, getting money for chalks, repairment of the facilities inside the school like benches and other things. For example, the examination papers or food for the teachers and other staff members.
We end up by conclude that Educare Secondary School and Mafiga A Primary School, both are organizations which provide education at Morogoro, but we end up by saying that the government should provide conducive environment for both organizations so that they can provide education for both the children living from the poor family and the one who living from the rich families.